supposed to elect somebody. Oh, you have a chair.
From our side, we're saying that we would like the language to be continued and to be continued to be taught in schools. Going against what Papa Ngā said, he's disagreeing with our language, but he's speaking in our language. I don't understand how you can disagree with something but still hold on to it. Secondly, as a Cook Islander, my language is my identity. If I do not have a language, I cannot say that I am a Cook Islander. So for now, I'll just leave that on the table. Thank you.
Hey, thank you.
Kia ora anta kato to tomato to ti nutre ni tato lare ti te kukare ni tato ti nutre ni tato e en ni tato ki u wako ke kukare. So kato na maro e tato e re ti tamo e te reo kwa. Moi te reo popoa, ki tū katau tā tātou ana, i roto pui ki e tutu ngā imitire, me tutu popoa rātou, me kite rātou tutu popoa. Mā mā o te ora, mā mā o te ora. Tō mā mana koe ki pra.
Issues about why they think that we shouldn't have to worry about the Māori language anymore, and I would like to address both of those. Firstly, Mama here, who said, we are in New Zealand now, so why do we speak, why do we need to speak Māori, why don't we speak English? And I would respond to that by saying, we are in New Zealand now, therefore we should be speaking Māori, because New Zealand is a country, a Māori-speaking country, a Māori land, where Māori is the language of the land, not our Māori, but the Māori of the political violence, but it's still Māori. It should not be English. English should not be the language that is spoken in this country at all. This is a Māori country where Māori is the language that should be spoken. So that's what I'll say to that. No English in New Zealand is what I'll say. And then to Papa here, who was worried about children speaking more than one language and having trouble with their languages, this is alluding to a well-known misconception about bilingualism that says that it's hard for children and young people to know more than one language. And that's actually scientifically inaccurate. Young children and babies are perfectly capable of speaking two languages, three languages, four languages, lots and lots of languages. If we feed them those languages, they will learn those languages. It doesn't harm them in any way at all. So I say, keep speaking, Māori. Thank you.
Kanan, everyone. So, as we all know, we're going to be arguing that Māori is important. A couple of the points raised by our team over here is mostly around the fact that we're in New Zealand and that we need to speak English so we can get jobs, have a good education, and do well in the employment sector, I guess. But we're in New Zealand, you're right. Our Auckland city is multicultural. There are so many different ethnicities, so many different cultures. We are so diverse, and what sets us apart from the rest of the rest of the cultures is that we are Cook Island. We, our culture, our identity, our language, our performances, everything is what makes us us. So when we are trying to get jobs, when we're in the education system, any system, if you're an employer looking to hire some people, you're gonna want to choose the one who's different from the others. What do we bring to the table? We bring our culture. We bring our identity. That's who we are. So our language is important. Our language is currently dying in Auckland or in New Zealand and back at home. So it's a really important issue that we need to address now. And I hope that from these talks we can do some things about it. Thank you.
Kia ora ana. Kakai tō e tōku leo. A leo ki rāme ngai e leo ki tēnō te kukai ni mene. E tano ai. Wau, e ka tika nei ia we, e hina ngaro nei ia we, e a kai ki papana tamari. Ko te tū, hana ki kone, a kai ki papa me na da happy. Tano wa na 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 happy. Na happy. Na happy hiyo hiyo. Lalo ke di mo matay. Akay chila ni ke lalo. Be hanu la ni da happy. Ngato. O de me de ye salai. Pero ke ni che pidi ni na na me de pidi me. Kedo papa. Matangai gini dia kemalam atu eh, bea, kakai cepat baik pun eh. Aku lepuh pinggau mian pun dah pipu dia kakai cepat eh. Tolio eh, pinggai gini dia nuwa di papa. Pudia mai buat pun eh. Kakai cepat eh, gede di papa. Hanau gue gikun eh. Tanau wana eh, pukian ini gue. Kali kalai nusir ini nih. Papa gak biar kata otor. Eko kula kalangai de yang dia ai bete a ya malam ma gue kai ti papa de hinu eko kali ni ado pau de eko ki ale ta do pau e tan mo ai a de la rua kalo de la de o ku kali ni de ya hinu musi de ni kai ti ta do de do de papa o de me papa la yu dia e papa The master cell papa. Kira anda?
Hello. I don't know how to speak like in general, so I'm just gonna talk from my own experience. I was born in Rara and I came here for schooling. So we had an education system and I learned English and everything. I love English. I love writing essays and reading. So like the English language to me was fine because that's what I learned. But then what I noticed growing up, my Cook Island language was lost because I was all my life I've learned English. And I mean, I understand the language and I know what my family are talking about, but it's just hard for me to say it. Like, I know what to say in my mind, but the way it comes out, it's not right. So it's hard for me to articulate what I'm thinking in my head in Māori, and it just comes out wrong. So that's just how I feel. And like growing up now, especially in university, just going off personal experiences of why I think it's important, was that last semester we did a presentation and it was for a Māori paper, and our lecturer said that she wants us to get up and speak like how the Māori do mihi. She wants us to either mihi or speak in our own language. And she really, what's the word? She was for it. If you could speak your own language and you know how to introduce yourself in your own language, then you do that. And I think I was the only one in my class who, I spoke our language. And everyone, like, how we had to do, I know that's the Māori word, but like, we fit it before we talk. And I remember, from our family reunion we had at the beginning of this year, we were taught the pe'es from Aitutaki by one of my papas. And so I thought, wow, okay, I'm going to speak my language because it's who I am, and it's like having grown up learning English, I now need to find my Cook Island language. So that's what I sort of struggle with now. And like just recently, I think it was yesterday, because I'm here at this campus studying midwifery, my name is a very long Cook Island name. And so I didn't want to change my name to shorten it, so I kept it the same long name because it's who I am. Finished.
Te karanga nei tētai tōtō,
me ere koe ki Roma, e rawe koe te anana a te tangata I Roma, ko marama koto I roto I tōko tūrea. No reira, I roto I te reo papa a, te karanga nei te roa tōko mana, te tamaiti ki tēra, e karaka a mei ema tōna me tōtā. Karaka tamaiti nene wara, e ue a mei ema tōna me tōtā. Ko tēra, tēra ka marama, ngai tēra a ira, tēra ira. Ere mai koutou te au metua, pae mai e tarato o tamari ki te ino. Ke a te tumu, ke api I te reo papanga. A ka ruke tō koutou reo haurikiko, te ia inoa, no te papanga. Nō rira, te akarang nei tā koutou tūtua I te ia awa te ki koutou, te akaro. Nō te mea, reka reka te metua, te tamari ki me tū I te rā pepa teite ia, te rā pare ato, me kare ai nei. I aka pē koutou I rau kai te rā pare, ea, no te reo papa. Kare no te reo mā, no te reo papa. Nā tēne rā reo papa, I apai a koutou I rau kai te rā pare, I rekare kai mamā e papa. E o te kera, me rira, Roka te ngāma meitake. Roka te rongo meitake. Yeah? Roka te rongo o te metua tāne, te metua waine, pera katoa te o te puna. Te reka reka o te ngākau, o ko tai I tā rātou o tamariki, kua roka I a rātou te reo papa a kare o rātou. Ne? Nō rira e te o tauira, te akaranga nei mātou I te e tua e. Tamu I a te reo papa a. Nā te papa a koe e apai, ki runga I te rā pare, tā koutou e tītau nei, I roto I te āpi I tuatau. Nēnā, te I reira, te au kite, te au kite e māmani. I nā ngaru koe te reira, ko kite koe ka hape e apai. Me ākara koe I te au māpu, me ākara koe I te au mea, tā au ka ina maro I te kimi, te reira, nā roto I te reo papa a. Mana koe ia, norara.
Good evening, everyone. Just going off the point that our mamas raised, you're saying that for us to get our degree or like our papers is based, it's because of the English language. Like, we have to forget the Māori language and learn the English language, and that will help you get your degree. Or that is how you will get your degree. Right? Okay. A point that we've come up with is that it's not necessarily the English language that helps us get our degree. Like, yes, it's there for support, but it's really us, it's like, it's our pride, it's ourselves. It's our state of mind. If we put our minds to it, like if we put our heads down and actually do the work, we will get our degree, regardless of whether or not you know English or Māori. So, yes, it's in English, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you should only learn English to get it, because the Māori language can help us. See, today, if you look at our education system, for example, our university systems, yes, our papers are in English, but they are also developing curriculums that allows bilingual students to still do those papers. So our Māori students, like, they have set up curriculums so that our Māori students can still get it. They translated the papers so that they understand it and they can still achieve those grades. So you don't necessarily have to be able to speak English. If we keep going the way we're going, like if we teach our children and everyone, like all the generations that are to come, if we teach them Māori, the universities, like all our education systems will see that it's important to us. So they will develop their curriculum so that our students can go to uni and achieve those papers in our language. You do see it happening in our secondary schools. For example, One Tree Hill College, they've got some of their curriculums in Kukaina Māori so that our Kukaina students can go and achieve the high grades. You don't necessarily have to be fully You don't have to be fluent in English to go and get an E and like say, you don't necessarily have to be fluent in English to go and get all the literacy credits. You can still get it in Kaila Māori. So saying that English, like we need to learn English and forget about Māori to get all those high grades is, yeah, it's another point for us.